dunk. There's a fire. Smoke detector. Wear goggles and rubber gloves when handling anything in this room. Hey Sam, do you want to see Pulp Fiction after school at the Coliseum? It came out last weekend and Todd won't shut up about it, so it's either good or we can make fun of him for liking it. My mom is supposed to cook dinner for us tonight for a change, but I can just ditch on it probably. What time? Also, isn't that movie supposed to be violent? Going to barf? According to Todd, it's pretty hardcore. I guess Uma Thurman gets stabbed in the heart with a heroin needle, so that's kind of hilarious. Also, something about cheeseburgers is important. Todd wants to see it again. 7:15, okay? Don't barf. Haha. Alright, see you then. And there's a cheeseburger barfing. Nothing down there. So this door there, I'm guessing there's another... Maybe not. Let's go in here. Oh, there's a bathroom. Oh, that's me making that noise. No blood, always a good thing. Cinnamon! Nailed it. Feeling blue. Well, what's that say? Hear that sound when I closed it? Lonnie rules. It's like an electric cabinet door. Wild color. Red light, red right hand. Semi-permanent comer. Not test on animals. Original formula. Blue.
Lonnie brought her hair dye over today. She said, I need to fix these roots. Think you could help? Dyeing hair is weirdly intimate. I don't know if I've touched someone else's scalp before. It's pretty intimate, right? It felt intimate. We looked into the mirror together after, and I expected her to say something about how it looked crappy, or good, or whatever. But that's when she said, you're so beautiful. And she was looking at me.
Aww.
Right in that moment, I wanted to say something, but I waited. And the moment was gone.
Pretty interesting here. Multi-pack. I remember that time I wiped my ass and... I mean, some really mundane things I hadn't picked up. See, now if I would think that's blood. If that wasn't there, and if we hadn't heard the diary, oh my god. You can't see the light under the door. Not a biggie. That doesn't work? There we go. Can't close that. Oh, it's mom's room. Or my parents' room. Oh, I never grabbed the phone and did stuff with it. I guess you get that. Dear Mom, Dad, and Sam... Oh, I have to hold it. What? I am in the channel? This is my second passage through the channel. I am on my way back from London, this time going to Brussels, Belgium. Sorry I didn't write you on the way to London, but I was too excited about the channel. London was great. Dad, I know you've always wanted to visit, and I think you really should. You'd love it. If you all wanted to come back here as a family sometime, I guess I could be convinced. Love you all, Katie. Holy Bible. Unknown Dimension Literature. Kaz Publisher. Communication must come total and conscious before we can stop it. William Seward Burroughs. And lights turning on is always a good thing. Oh my god, all these drawers. I'm overwhelmed by the drawers. That's a big drawer. We got a key in here. I want to find it. That was closed drawer. I don't know why I'm not getting used to that. And every once in a while I hear dunk. I don't like that. All the President's Men. Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. After that creak, I thought I heard a little hum. Like someone hummed, like, This game's freaking me out. Yeah. That's what you really want to be doing. Look at your parents' underwear. Mitten. One. What's it say? One cat? Dear Chan, oh honey, let me tell you, I understand how you feel. Bob and I have had our down periods. It's become a bit of a way of life, actually. You get used to each other. You live your own lives in the same house. The kids grow up. They go away. I'm sorry, this isn't helping, isn't it? Is it? Don't worry, Terry will get over with it if it's distracting him. Things will go back to normal. And as for Sam being distant, that's a teenager for you. Nothing to worry about. In the meantime, though, this controlled burn, that sounds like quite the adventure. But let's cut to the chase. This new ranger they sent, that's what I want to hear about. Ranger Rick? You have to be kidding me. It's too perfect. You have to tell me everything and send pictures. I want the whole package. Wait, that sounded wrong. Keep your chin up and until Terry is out of his slump. In the meantime, write more letters to your old friend Carol. She adores them. Love Carol. Was the mother going to have an affair with this guy, Rick? See, once in a while I hear dunk. That sounded like a fart. The mother is really... They're both really not attractive there, these parents. Sorry. So the light in here is already on. Watercolor technique for florals and still lifes. You guys can read that. Oh look, a ghost game. Escape from Ghost Mansion. Avoid the ghosts of Ghost Mansion and make your escape with your wits intact. A few of the shades you may encounter. The brothers, the cowboy, the widow, as you attempt to escape from Ghost Mansion. Where does it go? There. Guess we're done in here. I don't like when you can't close some doors. I'm worried that something's going to happen where you want to close the door, but you can't. I can't open any of these? Oh, that's different. Ugh. After the honeymoon, rediscovering your spouse personally, spiritually, sexually. Reverend Alexander Michaels. Yeah, that's what you really want. Telling you about this, a reverend. It may seem inevitable that Sparky, when your spouse shared on your honeymoon, should fade over time, but it doesn't have to be. Reverend Alexander Michaels will show you how to rekindle the fire you once had. Part 1 provides simple steps to reopen the lines of communication between you and your spouse, allowing you to face the problems you share as partners instead of rivals. Part 2 leverages the Reverend's decades of service to God, help you connect with a higher power. You'll draw strength from a spirituality you may not even know you have. Part 3 offers a number of fresh and exciting ideas from the bedroom, including a few things that may surprise you. Anal. The reserves of passion for your spouse run deep. You just have to know where to look. Reverend Michaels will show you the way. I'd rather flush it down the toilet, but I can't. So instead, I'll just flush the toilet. Nothing personal against reverends. Black friars for men. Well, we're not bound to find anything interesting in the bathroom. And I look down there. That's the bath. Went in there. Okay. The dark room. Do not enter if the red light. Red lights are on. They're on. Katie, Mom and Dad were going to make up the guest room for you to stay in over the summer, but you came home on such short notice that they weren't around to do it. You can use my room if you want. I won't be needing it anymore, Sam. Why not, Sam? I hate going in here dark. Books. So how long have they lived here? Ghost Hunter Journal. Sighting Journal. August 31st, 1994. A tall shadow in the upstairs hall. When I rounded the corner, no one was there. How tall was Uncle Oscar? Note. I was not wearing my glasses. I really don't want to see ghosts. September 3rd, 1994, 12:44 a.m. A faint voice coming from the bottom of the stairs. I said hello. Did not investigate. Probably was the furnace. September 9, 1994. Poured milk from carton in fridge. It was spoiled. Pretty sure I read that spirits can sour milk. Milk was just bought yesterday. Ooh. Also ghost milk. Ooh. October 9, 1994. Lonnie says she feels a presence in the TV room. I suddenly began to feel cold. We built a protective pillow for it. Seen that. Lonnie and I employ Ouija board as a medium. Disturbing messages are conveyed from the other side. Oscar is definitely here. October 28th. Enlisted Lonnie to stay up all night and help patrol premises, recording any signs of otherworldly presence. Lonnie reported many sightings, but all remained unconfirmed. Possible ectoplasm in attic. Probably leaky roof. Sample taken just in case. Despite due to our best efforts, we both fell asleep around 4 a.m. All in all, a successful night. I really don't want to find ghosts. You don't want to. Do not require. That's all my stuff, Katie. Someone likes to paint. Performance evaluation for Richard Pattermack? Supervisor O'Janice. Oh, this is Rick the Ranger. Ranger Rick. Janice Greenbrier. Exemplary in everything. Knowledge and skill, communication, work ethics, safety procedures, punctuality, and overall. Ranger Pattermack has been indispensable during the course of the prescribed burn preparation and execution. I believe his expertise and dedication has been a deciding factor in the success of a very complex and challenging conservation effort. Drink. In the opinion of the Flintlock Forest staff, Rick's contributions to daily operations have become essential to the outfit continuing success. To this, I will be formally submitting paperwork requesting his permanent reassignment to this facility. Okay. So he's either is very good, or she really likes him, or both. Halloween show. The Misfits, they're awesome. Spell bomb. Unless it's a different group than I'm thinking. Don't forget your costume. Stygian Lounge, 10:29, 9 p.m. Downtown. See you there.
Sometimes you just have to lie to Mom and Dad. Like when Lonnie asked me to see a band with her and stay over at her friend's place in the city after. That's a lie to Mom and Dad situation.
It was Betsy.
But it was so worth it. The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome. And everybody was moving together like one huge tide of sound. Between two songs, Lonnie leaned over and said, "How do you like your first show?" I was so happy. I felt tears starting in my eyes. And then she up and hugged me. I think she could tell.
That's cute. That's kind of spooky. Let me see it better. Oh. Can you see this? Captain Allegra and the First Mate. Your costume, my costume. Oh, they have costumes together. And stories about each other. Lonnie. Holy crap, I was in the library and I noticed something in the corner and I found a secret passage. And it had Oscar's creepy old stuff in it. Oh my god, I have got to see this. We're skipping the sixth. Secret passage from the library. Oh, I have to go down and check that out. To downstairs. It goes from one of the... It goes from the bathroom. I wonder if you can just get in that way. Healthy choices. Skills for a healthful life. Okay. Creepy stuff. In the secret passage. Oh! Neat. I can't open this drawer. There's something down there? No, just more books. Well, before I go that way, look for this passage. Here? from here. Oh my. No light? I stopped for a second. Ghost Hunter. Sam and Lonnie's secret house investigation log. Hidden compartments found 3. Library, upstairs hall, and foyer. Evidence of supernatural discovered. Locked. There's X here. To basement. There's an X there. What's all this stuff? Neckwear? Old pages? Look at that. Huh? So downstairs. Wait, what am I doing? What's the X? Too bad it doesn't show us where in here we are. So we came in there. Yeah, frame rate hits here. Is X the evidence of supernatural? I'm not seeing anything yet, not that I'm complaining. So, this is like I'm in the room. Yeah, it's over here, I think. Seeing anything. And there's also a X outside the office. Outside in the hall. So I'm going to go outside in the hall. And make a that would be a left. That sounds like growling. By the entrance to the foyer. So I'm not seeing anything where these X's are. Where's the library again? TV room. Here. So everything else is locked. This, Sam's dark room. Oh boy. Don't want to go in here very much. Locked. So I missed a key somewhere. These lights. What could this combination be? And where's this key? Samantha, huh. Special, adorable, merry, affectionate, nice, thoughtful, honest, admirable. Well, I heard a strange noise. I gotta look for this key. Or find out this combination. Well, I hear like a humming. In here, talks about a combination. A standard combination lock. And that's it. I gotta look for a key. I think I'm gonna sign off here. You know, I've been playing for almost 2 hours. I'll sign off here so I can look for a key and or find a combination for the locker. If I open the locker, maybe the key's inside there. I just gotta look for clues of what numbers. You know what? Yeah, I'll sign off here. Okay, thanks so much for watching, guys, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.